Okay, I was wanting to do a quick video rundown of the Nocta 4's Core Gold Plus model. And the Plus model is on 19 kilohertz versus the old Core Gold that was on 15. So they've upped the frequency to 19 kilohertz. And for the most part, the menu and everything is about the same as the core models, the Relic and Coin model, also the gold model as far as the menu is. But there's a couple of little extra things in there. But the first key things we're going to look at is the control box has dust proof headphone jack cover. Got the dust proof, well, I guess splash proof power switch. It's got the membrane switches. And over here, it's got your ground tracking, is also the splash proof, dust proof switch cover. And also, your ground grab button, instead of the exposed button, is now covered with some sort of a rubbery, poly-filling, very durable button cover. Looks like it'd have a long life. And plus, your ground grab here. Wait, so that's your ground grab, I'm sorry. Your pinpoint has the same cover. And then you still have your light for low light conditions or night hunting. And the new rod, I don't know if you can see it or not, now has a hole in the bottom of it to let the water out if you're like hunting in the creeks or whatever, to let the water drain out of the inside of the rod instead of accidentally keeping water inside the rod and maybe climbing back up a hill and flushing water back into the electronic some way. So you got an outlet for your water if there's any inside the rod. New coil bolts. These are a much harder durable plastic than the older ones. I mean, I don't know. These things look bulletproof. They're very, very hard. And the coils are also very rugged. I mean, super rugged ears on these things. Plus with reinforcement spots here, I can see on the sides. Real rugged coil. The that's a double D 5x10. That's the coil that comes with it. Plus, it also has a round 5. It's not the out of round. This is actually a 5-inch round double D. This comes with the Core Plus. It has a coil cover on it. And it's also, as you can see, it's a different style coil. It's reinforced. It's real heavy duty. Plus, we also have the option now of having a elliptical 5x10 concentric. And it's built just like the 5x10 double D, but it's concentric. And I've ran it some in some modern trash and some tin, some old 1880s tin, and it does help a whole lot with this high frequency, having a concentric coil. And that's a tight concentric coil too, and it does help a whole lot on the faulting of tin and things like that that plague double D coils, like bottle caps and things. And this has a comes with the coil cover on it also, right here. So, and this coil cover will fit on the other concentric coil too. So, with all that said, what I'm going to do is turn the machine on. I've used it. I've got about 15 hours on this machine. It's sort of dirty, so you know it did look better than this when I got it, but I've got it pretty dirty. But I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on, and it'll come on in all metal. You can set it to come on in discriminant mode, but the factory has it set up to come in all metal. I've left it for the factory mode till I did a video. Then I'm just going, because it does have the ability to have a memory, save your settings and all that. But it comes on in general. And this machine has something called ISAT, which is the SAT is self-adjusting threshold. And the I would be intelligent SAT. So what it does basically is, as you go up, how much faster the threshold sets itself to retune. I don't know if you can hear it or not, but see how fast it is. That's like a hyper gain here. And then you can slow it down. That's on 5, 4 factories. Settings 3 when it first comes from the factory. There's 2. There's 1. See, it slows it down. It gives it a slower retune speed. And that would, slower retune speeds would give you more depth and more mineral-free dirt. But as your dirt gets worse, and you're in all metal hunting, you'll start getting where your threshold will drop out or not want to hold. And so the faster retune will smooth some of that out. Plus you can, let's bring it back up to 3. That's the factory setting. And we can go to the threshold. You can hear that threshold. See how smooth that is? It's a very sensitive machine. And that's with the sensitivity on 50. And you can bring the sensitivity up. But when you get out in the dirt, you're going to want to get it running smooth before you start trying to bring the sensitivity up with the SAT control here. If you, actually, the dirt I've got around here, this 3, is a little tricky to run. I like 4 a little better, but I lose some depth too. But anyway, that's for your hunting in all metal mode. But I'm not a gold prospector, so what I'm using the machine for is relic hunting. And I must say, this is a very, very good relic machine for just if you want to dig relics out of iron or relics out of bad dirt, and all you're really interested in if it's ferrous or non-ferrous. I've ran it for, I said, about 15 hours, and I can actually tail iron before I did. I could tell the size of the iron or the shapes of the iron and even the depth with the way the modulated audio is. And I decide if I want to, you know, dig it or not. And when I'm relic hunting, I want to dig anything bigger than nails usually anyway out of a side if it's promising. And this machine really talks to you good about the iron sizes. And it's also a quite deep machine. It's probably one of the deepest 19 kilohertz machines I've ever ran. And it's got two discriminant modes. And the first one is, they call it FST, which is a fast mode. And what that is, it's a light and fast. It would be, if you had a dais, it would be like having your dais on about 4 reactivity. And then it's got a boost mode. And the boost mode, believe it or not, and everything I can tell, it's like running a T2 F-75 in a boost mode. It's got that same type response, yet it's on 19 kilohertz. If that makes sense, it's super, super hot on low conductors, even low conductors at depth. I've dug smaller, lower conductors at depth with this machine than I can think back, and I just can't remember digging smaller, lower conductors, not on a, you know, continuous basis. I've had it in about 3 or 4 different dirt sites, from good to extremely bad. And that's the one thing that'll stick out in your mind, is you're digging 7-8 inch small, you know, items, like little buttons, the little pistol balls. They jump out at you on this boost mode. So what I've found is just getting accustomed to the machine for walking, scouting, I run boost. And then when I come into the iron, I drop back to fast. So let me just show you the differences from boost to fast. And I'm just going to go ahead and go into fast mode. Let me go back up here. There's fast mode. And this is sort of neat too. When you're in fast, when you're in any of the discriminant modes, the sensitivity's on 50. I'm just going to leave it right there since I'm in the house. Your ISAT won't work. Your ID mask, I'm just going to leave it at 10. That just, anything below 10, I just will not hear. But, leave the volume on 20. Your tone's going to be at 4 from the factory. And what that means is that when it's at 4, it's in a single tone. There's 5 tones, but when it's on 4, it's single tone. So, wherever you set your ID filter, is just like a regular meltator. Anything below the setting you won't hear, anything above it you will. But for working iron, I'm going to put it on 5, which is the high tone, the highest of the tones. And now it'll be in a two-tone mode. Anything below 40 will be a iron grunt. Anything above 40 is going to be a high tone. So I'll let you hear it. I've got it set for the iron tone and the ferrous, non-ferrous tone. So here's the iron. And then here's the high tone. And you'll notice this machine doesn't overload neither. It will, but you've got to stick it right on the... Well, I can't get it, actually. It'd take a bigger target than that coin to make it overload. So, I guess the best thing to do is just let you hear the nail test using the Indian head penny. So, I'm just going to go ahead and do the whole nail test for you. This is going to be Indian head penny in the middle here. Going to do the number one sweep. And you can see how fast the machine is. Now we'll go to 2. See how fast that is. It's an extremely fast machine when you're in the fast mode. Here's 3. And the target ID jumps all over the place. Just that was, oh, let me do 4. Okay, let me get that too. And Now, the target ID on this machine is more about tone than it is the ID. The ID is just all over the place usually when I'm digging targets. I've had shotgun holes all over the place. I've had round balls all over the place to get them out of the dirt. So, I mean, this is a relic gold machine, we should say. Relic and gold, that'd be a good name for it, actually. Let's see. Here's the number one on the bigger nail. Number two. Three. Now here comes the hard one, which I like to call down the barrel. As you can hear, there's no problem hitting that target. And it works real well in iron. With even that coil, that 5 by 10 coil. You know, I did that video the other day of the three machine shootout. And the reason I did it was because I was wanting to test it against this machine, those 3 5x10s against this machine. And this machine holds its own very well. And trying to find a piece of iron here. That machine holds its own very well with those others. And actually, it's hotter on the smaller stuff in iron than those other machines. You can just tell by running it. There's a piece of iron. And I'll tell you, out of all the machines I've ran, this audio on this machine and the way it hits big iron reminds me a whole lot of the F-19. You'll dig relic iron, but you won't dig just every little thing. I was trying to find some relic iron over here. I don't know if I've got anything laying out or not. Let's see here. There's an iron buckle. See how it hits? It's on that, but like that, you wouldn't dig it. I mean, unless you're just in a site and you want to dig big iron. But that, so it likes to jump on the relic iron. And I like that a lot myself. And actually, just running the machine for 15 hours, I've got a feel for it, and it's just a heck of a relic unit. I mean, it's just, that's what, it's just a relic machine. And that's what most relic hunters are looking for nowadays when they're trying to dig these remaining relics. We gravitate toward hot gold machines with a discriminator on them. And there's just not a whole lot of options out there. You know, each company's making a gold machine, but you know, there's just one option from every company. And, this one here, this core, Nocta Core Gold Plus, is just really a hot relic machine. And, I mean, you can just feel it running it, and just the way it snags on targets. There's some targets I dug today. And if you'll look at them, they was all, like, here's a little button back, and here's a little two little, that little saddle tacks. And here's a little small button, little flat thin button. There's a coin button. And see these little round balls here, these little pistol size, carved lead, pistol bullet. I think that's a Colt, part of a J hook. And some kind of a button with a, it's got a lion's head or something. I can't make it. Some kind of a head on it. But now this was in a campsite. This was just a day for about 3 hours in a campsite that I had really hunted hard. And it was pulling stuff out of there quite easily at 8-inch depth, that smaller stuff at 8-inch depths. So it really jumps on that kind of stuff down in the ground, at, you know, 8 inches. And I'm sure if I was somewhere, I could dig a 12-inch coat button. I mean, that's just the way you get a feel for it. It'd jump on something like that. But let me show you the differences in the depth of the machine from boost to normal. This is, or not boot, not normal, but fast mode. Let me just, I want to go ahead and go back up to the sensitivity, and I'm just going to go ahead and run the sensitivity up as high as I can. That's 94. And let me test it with a nickel, if I got one. If I had a nickel laying here, where did I have? Here's a nickel, and we're in two-tone, we're on about 95 sensitivity, and this is fast mode, and I'm getting it right there at the cam lock, and the cam lock is 14, let's see where am I at. 14 or 14 and a half, something like that, at the cam lock. And that's the fast mode. Now let's go to the boost mode. Come back down. In this boost mode, it slows down. Try 92. It slows the target response down and gives it more depth. And this is the only, seriously, it's like a F-75 or T-2 type response. Like an older F-75, not with a digital shield type response. It's the older type feel. And that gives me about 2 more inches. I was doing about 16 right then on that. And that's at 92. So I think you can see that the boost mode, I don't know how many people's ran the older F-75s or T-2s with the boost processors, but it's got that feel. And I'll let you hear. Hang on, let me make sure I'm in. Tone 5, there we go. And, this is the boost with the iron. See how it's a little different sounding now when I go down the barrel. When you're in, compared to the fast mode, it'll still do this. But it's a little more sluggish, but it's got depth like nobody's business. I mean, let me do a ground grab real quick. And let me just show you this nickel right here. I know you can't see that from the video, but that nickel right there, that's 12, 13 inches off the ground. It's probably more than this. That's pretty good ways up there. So it's definitely hot. It's like a, the best way I can describe the machine, it's like a F-19 or a Gold Bug Pro with a boost processor on it. I mean, that's the best way I can describe it. But it unmasks better with coil for coil. I can drop down to the 6-inch coil, and it unmasks beautifully, you know. So, but I like doing the 5x10 in the 5x10 testing, because that's just one of my favorite coils. And that coil there on this machine, it reminds me of a F-75 or a T2 processing. The boost processing, that's the only part of it that reminds me of the boost processing. But it's like you took a F-19 or something and put a boost process on it, if that makes sense. But it's still got the Nocta macro ability to blend and bleed targets together that the American manufacturers do not do. The American manufacturers, you know, they're on-off digital type reports. These machines here are real blendy and bleedy. They'll give you the whole picture as you go across. The audio gate just stays open the whole time you're passing something, you know, passing a target. It just does like a calliope report. It just blends it all together. So, and that's something that Nocta and Macro has been doing with their machines. And it don't require us to actually have the tone break, user defined tone break. We can use a factory set tone break, just like the other machines are doing, like a F-75s, T2s, things like that. But these actually blend the targets together. And to be honest with you, I wouldn't even want a tone break, or a tone break that I could set. Because the way the factory's doing it, I couldn't dial it in no better myself. With my hearing, I couldn't get it no better. So, unless they go to a different setup or something, they've got the market cornered on this right here, is the way they blend targets together. Now, if they went to a different machine where they had a tone break, I don't know if you could actually use it to your advantage, unless you use it to your advantage to actually bring the tone break up. And what I'm saying is, maybe in some heavy iron, you could bring it up higher. But I would never want to take it no lower than where it's at right now. So, great setup they've got right here. And very unique machine. I mean, this is, when some relic hunters get a hold of these things and run them through some of their old camps with just that coil right there, they're going to be amazed at the smaller items that's laid in those camps at depth. Because, I mean, this thing really does punch the dirt. And it has the tendency not to call non-ferrous ferrous at depth. A deep nail, like a foot deep, I've dug some foot deep nails with it, but believe it or not, I knew there was nails before I dug them. They had the signature sound to them. I knew there was nails, but I went ahead and dug them just to make sure they was, I ain't gonna say I knew there was nails, I knew there was a piece of iron down there. But they had that signature sound to them, that blue bleep, blue bleep, blue bleep, you know, with a little splatterings of high tone here and there, that, foot deep nail, you know, the little square nails, it just jumps on them and digs them, but you know it's the square nails. So that's when you can start getting selective on your relic iron is go after the stuff you want to, leave the stuff you don't want. It's got a good audio system that talks to you. Now, for the gold hunters, I could do a little test, but I mean, I'm not a gold hunter, but I love machines like this for relics. It'll come on in the general search, all metal mode. And it does have the auto tracking, but I should have mentioned that. It's got the auto tracking if you want to use it. When auto tracking's turned on, it'll, this right here blinks to let you know it's tracking. But let me do a ground grab real quick. My ground's doing about 80. But this is the general search mode. Threshold's at 55. The sat's at 3. Sensitivity's at 50. And let me just run a nugget by it. Let me turn this box long ways. Hang on. I want to use just a small nugget. Let me see. This one here is a 0.6 gram, I believe. Let's see. Oh, 0.6 grain. I'm sorry, 0.6 grain. Now on that 0.6, I can get it out to about 2 inches, get a threshold waiver at 50 sensitivity. I've got this other one here. It's a little bit bigger, and this is probably more of what most people would find. This is a 3.9 grain right here. And I'm hitting that out 6 inches, a little past 6 inches, actually. And I mean, that's, let me get my hand in here so you can see it. But I mean, that's a small little nugget. That's probably what most people would get excited about, something that size. And as you can see, that just jumps all over that little nugget. Let me go to a discriminant mode and see what it does on that nugget and fast. I'm going to turn the fast on. And let me check my sensitivity on that. I'm going to run that sensitivity up to 95. Gonna be a two-tone. Let me go back and grab that long nugget. Looks like a piece of a flat rice. See what it'll do in discriminant mode with this nugget. I'm looking at about 5 3/4 where I can actually get it to repeat. So that's dropping off what, a half inch from the all metal side. So again, amazing, really. Let me try it in slow. If you had some real good dirt, you might get a, I'm not slow, I'm sorry, boost. If you had some real good dirt, telling how deep this thing would go. But I know gold appears in bad soil. Let's see what I can get away with here. I'm going to get it to 94 and leave it. Put it back down here on thigh. Ooh, she's sparky. And that's what I like about this machine. It reminds me of the hyper gain units. I mean, it's just wanting to hunt, and you can just tell by the way it sounds. See how slower it is when the boost mode? I'm getting 6.25 repeat on that, so that's about the same as it was on 50 sensitivity and all metal. So I'm going to try to get some live hunts with it the next couple of days, and also show the concentric coil, maybe in some tin. But I just want to do this preliminary video just to show you what's going on with the machine. And I'm a relic hunter at heart. I'm not a gold hunter, but I gotta tell you, of all the products I've tried, from Macro Racer to Nocta Cores, just within the few amount of hours I've ran this thing, I mean, I really have taken to it. It's just a hyped up, it's a hyper gain, hyped up relic machine. I mean, I know it's a gold machine, but that's what the relic hunters are looking for. And this thing's really, really what you want to relic hunt with. I mean, I ain't worried about the ID system and all that. It's just, if it's iron or not, not ferrous or non-ferrous, that's what I'm looking for. And this machine here, it'll punch down in the dirt and gives targets a fighting chance. It don't just like to call everything iron. It wants you to dig some targets. And that's what you, in sights I hunt where they're depleted, I mean, this is just a relic hunter's dream for me. It's just it's a tool. It's a surgical tool too. So I can't give it enough praise in just a short amount of time I've ran it. I wish I'd have had this machine 25 years ago. I mean, you could have cleaned some places slap out and got your fair share and other people wouldn't have got. I mean, it would have sure enough cleaned up a spot. But okay, I'm going to go ahead and sign off. And maybe I've shown you enough about the machine to let you know, if you think it's something you might like or not. I didn't show you the ground tracking, but I mean, it's the same as the other models, it's got an excellent ground tracking system on it. It locks right in. I mean, it's good as a MXT in my opinion. It just locks right onto the ground and tracks very well too. It doesn't over track, I've noticed. Seems like it wants to hold. The only real complaints I have about the machine, and it's the same on the older core too, or the fours. This is the fours gold, but the fours core and the gold is these armrests. Let me turn this thing off. I wish the armrest on either machine come up higher, at least another inch. Because what I find when I'm hunting is, as I'm swinging, I like to, maneuver the coil, and your arm wants to roll out of the armrest because the armrest don't wrap up on the sides high enough. I'd love to see another inch on the sides of that thing in a more of a, like the Mine Labs do on their GPXs and stuff. They really come up on the sides, and that would take away from that pivoting feel you get with it. But if that thing had a high armrest sides on it, which it'd be a simple fix from the factory, they just bring them up a high, inch higher, You got you a good swinging unit. Okay, that's about all I can think of that I'd really, don't find appealing is the armrest. But everything else is, they've taken care of the coils, the coil bolts, the drain holes. All the switches now are rubberized. And we've got us a 19 kilohertz relic machine is what I'm going to call it. Y'all can call it a gold machine. I'm calling it a relic machine. Okay, I appreciate it.